Next up, we're going to talk a little bit about Gmail add-ons. And these are my favorite add-ons for enhanced productivity. What I mean by this allows you to share and collaborate with your team. It also allows you to get work done a little faster yourself. The first one that I like to share is called multiple inboxes. And this is one of the best features of Google that used to be hidden away in their menus that you had to enable. And now it's right here in the limelight. And when I click on the settings wheel in the top right-hand corner, I can enable that by switching my inbox to multiple inboxes. Now you can see here inside my emails, I've got my draft emails up the top. I've got a list of emails here called Peter to Action. Any of my start emails appear here. And then I have my main inbox as well. And these are effectively the different lists of emails that I've told the multiple inboxes set up that I want to have inside my inbox. Now I use this as, let's say, a kind of productivity mode for email. When you are clearing out your emails, imagine you're walking to the post office box in front of your house and you're picking up all your emails, picking up all your letters, and you bring those inside your house, you put them on the kitchen table, and what do? We put them in piles. The junk mail we throw straight in the recycling bin, any bills to pay, we maybe, you know, tack them onto the fridge, and then if we get a postcard from grandma, maybe we put that on the countertop. But what we're doing is we're triaging our emails and we're putting them into different folders. And one of the things that we teach in our inbox domination course, which is free for our customers, is that when you put your emails into different piles, you want to be using labels for those. And we call those action labels. And so inside my Gmail, you can see here that I have a label called Peter to Action. And this is basically my action label where I want to put emails into when I can't deal with them right now inside my inbox. So I'm going to show you guys what it looks like to create an action label, because you probably want to have a few for your business. I'm down to one, but for most people, when they start with this process, they're going to use a couple. So the first one I'll create is pay. And you can see I put an ampersand there, so it appears right up the top. Let's create another label, and you could call that to reply. Let's create another label, and I'll call that to call. Create another label, and I'll call that to delegate. And so each one of these labels here is going to sit up on the left-hand side of your inbox. And then if we open an email and we decide, hey, you know what, I can't deal with this email right now, but this would be something that would be good to delegate, I'm going to move it out of my inbox, and I'm going to move it into the to delegate label. Right, and I'm going to go through the next email, going to open it up, and I might move this one into pay, right? And then bit by bit, I'm going to be triaging through my inbox and getting my inbox down to zero each day by moving emails that I need to deal with later into those triage folders. Now, am I just abdicating here? Am I just pushing and kicking the can down the road at actually dealing with these emails? It's a very valid question. I get it each time I teach this. I would rather you have a bottom drawer full of bills that you don't get to, rather than all of your letters overflowing out of your mailbox on the street. And the reason for that is, if the mailbox is overflowing on the street, you might not get delivery of your, I mean, you are always going to get emails delivered to Gmail, it's never going to run out of storage, but you might not know what's urgent and what's not urgent. You might not be able to see the urgent emails that come in because they're hidden in a mess of non-urgent emails. And so that's why we use the action labels. And then when we configure our multiple inboxes, we can have those action labels actually show up here. And so let's go ahead and go into our multiple inboxes. We'll customize them. And from here, you can see these are just our search queries. So is drafts, is starred, label Peter to Action, label to call. Let's bring up our label pay. And we'll hit save. And then from there, I think we put one email into the pay list. Here we go. You can see that one email that I put into the pay list actually shows up in the pay list there. And so that's how we use multiple inboxes to triage and work through our emails, place them somewhere else. And then when we're ready, we go into the label and we actually work through the emails. Now, once I've replied to that email or I've dealt with the email, I can just remove the label and it disappears, and then that pile is done. And it's kind of akin to getting to the end of the week, paying all your bills, you grab them all from the bottom drawer, and one by one you go through paying all of your bills. I decide to do each one of my email piles or each one of my action labels in batches because it means that I'm not in complete overwhelm with all the emails sitting in my inbox. What most people do is they spend their whole day just sitting in and out of their inbox, and pop-ups come through and new emails ding and bing and annoy you and you know, distract you from what you're doing. And we're forever in this place of basically like half doing email and half trying to do the rest of our work. And let me tell you, for myself, I've got my email down to less than about 10 or 15 minutes a day, and it is bliss because I've got heaps of productive time to do other tasks. So the next most important feature of Gmail is the ability to work with a team. And out of the box with Gmail, there's a couple of little tricks where you can share your mailbox and give someone else access to it. That's called delegated mailboxes, and we've got a video dedicated to how to share your mailbox between different users on the Google platform. Check out our YouTube channel for that. But one of the most important tools that we use when we want to share labels between our team is a tool called Hiver. Now, itGenius is a reseller of this tool, so if you're interested in the product, we have access to discounts, professional support, and other bonuses of buying Hiver through us. It doesn't cost you any extra, but you get a bunch of extra value, so have a chat to our team if you're interested. What Hiver lets you do is have a shared label system. So right inside your Gmail, you can have labels shared between different team members. And some of the best features of this is the ability to assign an email to someone so you can make someone a point of responsibility. You can have a particular email shared mailbox, which is dedicated to your delivery for your customers. So we have hello@itgenius.com, which is for all of our sales conversations, and our account management team use that as well. And then we have help@itgenius.com, which is for all of our account queries, for our support team, for our projects team, and everyone uses their mailboxes inside of Gmail to actually access this. You can also see here that you can write an internal note and actually share internal notes on an issue or on an email that comes in between your team members, which makes it nice and easy to keep the internal notes and the conversation flow all tracked inside each conversation. And then inside of Hiver, when you are replying to an email to a customer, the customer just sees the shared mailbox. And so if you want all of your staff to be using help@yourcompanyname.com, then this is a great tool to be able to do that, because it allows everyone to basically access the same mailbox and share that with each other. Great tool. And if you're interested in it, make sure you have a chat to our team. The next one I want to talk about is called Inbox When Ready. And this is my favorite plugin for Gmail by far. It's probably the only one that I use on a day-to-day basis, even though I do test lots of different plugins and features from time to time. Now, inside my Gmail here, you will notice up the top, I have a little option here to hide the inbox. And this actually happens automatically after about 15 minutes of no activity. What that means is that I can access my Gmail mailbox anytime I need to search for an email, compose an email, reply to a chat message, dig up something from a label, or even access my calendar on the right-hand side here, now that everything has been consolidated. And I can easily, from there, with one click, show my inbox and get into my inboxes and my emails that are sitting in the inbox waiting for me only when I want to. There is a perpetual problem with email, and that is that we're constantly getting distracted by it. And what I find is, if I'm working on a task in my drive, or I'm working on a task on a meeting, and I want to go and search my emails for something that was sent to me a couple of weeks ago, I find myself immediately checking the new emails that have come in, and we can't help it. The dopamine fires, the cortisol fires, and all of a sudden, we're jumping into what new emails have come in because they're exciting, or maybe they're worrying, or whatever. We're basically addicts to the emails that come in. And so what this does is it actually hides that, and it restricts your ability to see the new emails that have come through. There's a paid program for this if you don't want it to show up on your signature, and I would highly, highly recommend that. The next one that I recommend is called Ystamp, and this one allows you to create a sexy signature for your Gmail. Now, personally, I don't use this because I just have a little text signature, but for those of you that want to have a really, really great looking signature, it's called Ystamp. And so if I go to ystamp.com, I'm just going to go ahead and Google it here. It is ystamp.com. Let's open it up. You can basically generate your own signature. So you go ahead and sign in, you put in all of your details. So I've got itGenius here, put in my, title, probably put that correct. Here we go, put in my phone number. All right, great. And so if you want to upload a photo, you can upload a photo, do all of those kind of things. You click the done button, you sign in, and then it's going to automatically deploy it into your Gmail account. So if you're looking for a way to create really great looking professional signatures, which have all of the links and everything in there perfectly, then this is a great way to do that.